Hi, I'm Smarty Pants. You may recognize me from seeing the Big Balloon Show at the Prairie Trails Public Library. Or maybe you've seen me on WGN Morning News.
Yeah. The leader of the crazy pack for us, it's Smarty Pants. Good morning.
Good morning.
Today I've got something special. With the support of the Prairie Trails Public Library, you can watch the Big Balloon Show right here on your computer. So let's start the show.
Smarty, it's time to get up. Smarty, you have to get up. Smarty, you're gonna miss your show.
I'm gonna miss my own show.
Big Balloon Show.
Hi, I'm Smarty Pants. You may already know me from seeing the Big Balloon Show at your local library or at your school or even at a local theater near you. Well, now I'm doing my show right here on your computer. So do you kids want to see some more big balloons today?
Yeah!
I can't hear you. Do you want to see some more big balloons today?
Yeah!
There must be something wrong with my microphone. I can't hear you. Do you guys want to see more big balloons today?
Yeah!
I was hoping you'd say that. So let's start the show with some more big balloons.
Hey Chef Smarty, come to my party. Make me something to eat. Hey Chef Smarty, come to my party, make me something sweet.
Hello everybody, I'm Chef Smarty and today we are going to be making a delicious balloon banana birthday cake. But before we get started, repeat after me. Ready? Let's get cooking! This time with enthusiasm! Let's get cooking! Okay, now to make our balloon birthday banana cake, the first thing we are going to need is some ingredients. Right here in my refrigerator. The first ingredient that we are going to need is one delicious banana. The second ingredient we are going to need is one delicious banana. The third ingredient we are going to need is one delicious banana. You kids catch on quick, huh? The next ingredient we are going to need is one delicious banana with a bad, bad sunburn. I think this one is going to peel. The next ingredient we are going to need is one delicious... Aren't you glad I didn't say banana? The next ingredient is one delicious banana made from delicious bubble gum. The bubble gum scraped from underneath desks of second graders all over the city. disgusting. The next ingredient we are going to need is one delicious baby banana. Oh, so cute. Baby banana doo-doo-doo. Baby banana doo-doo-doo. Baby banana doo-doo-doo. Baby banana. And last but not least, a few more ingredients I didn't have time to make jokes for. Thank you, Penny. Now, ready? Let's get cooking! The first thing we have to do is get these balloons into business, getting them twisted together. It's like balloon twisting in 3D. Here we go. Now be careful. These balloons are very, very fragile. So, that must be one of the popular ones. Now hold on to your balloons very carefully. Do not let them fall on the ground. If you drop your balloon ingredients on the floor, no one will want to eat your cake. Is it looking like a cake yet? No? Tough crowd. All right, here we go. We give it some more twists. Some more twists. Some more twists. What's that? You think my cake looks like an octopus? You must be a real comedian. Here we go. Now, one more twist here. One more twist here. Is it ready to eat?
No.
Well, of course not. You have to put the cake in the oven before you eat it. What kind of chef do you think I am? So we put it right into the oven. Here we go. You have to help. You have to help me heat it up. Put your hands together like this. Very, very fast. You're very, very fast. Not so fast. You'll burn yourself, Barry Allen. A little more twisting. A little more. Throw the heat. Throw the heat. We put it into the oven. And here we go. And we have a delicious balloon banana birthday cake. Bon appetit. Buongiorno, and I'll see you next time.
Wow, that Chef Smarty really can cook. And if you'd like to start cooking something in your own kitchen, ask your librarian to help you find some of the cookbooks. Mmm, cookies. And I bet you'll be cooking up something nutritious in no time. Or should I say, delicious. This guy goes to the doctor and says, "Doctor, you gotta help me. I'm having terrible memory problems. I forgot where I work, and I lost my job. I couldn't remember my wife's name, and now she's really mad at me. I took my dog for a walk, and I forgot his leash, and he ran away. Doctor, you gotta help me." The doctor says, "How long have you been having these problems?" And the guy says, "What problems?"
Hi, I'm Smarty Pants. People ask me a lot of questions. Here's one from my cousin Martine. He lives in France.
Pourquoi est-ce que les gens t'appellent Smarty Pants?
Great question, Martine. Why do people call me Smarty Pants? Well, I like to think I'm pretty smart, and I got that way by reading books. Like this one. Lots of books. Like these. I even got my degree in science, geology.
Yep, it's a rock.
But my favorite books to read are science books. Balloon science, that is. The razor sharp nail, the balloon's worst enemy. You get too close and kablooey. But we can save our balloon with science. Science. The razor sharp nail, we place it inside. We place our nail into the plate, one single balloon. We lower our plate down. Now's a good time to cover your ears. Ready? We apply pressure, and the balloon is popped. Now instead of just one nail, let's go with 1,000. And now we have 1,000 nails. Our balloon, and my very bestest friend, and number one most awesomest daughter, Penny Pants. We take our balloon on the 1,000 nails. We place our top plate down. Here we go, carefully, 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 carefully. But let's add a little bit of pressure with a little bit of pineapple.
Thank you, Penny. It's pineapple, delicious and nutritious. Each can of pineapple weighs 2 pounds. There's one. There's two. There's three. There's four. Should we keep going? Oh yeah. 5, 6, 7, 8 cans of pineapple. Should we stop now? No way. 9, 10, 11, 12 cans. A full dozen cans of pineapple. 2 pounds apiece. That's 24 pounds of pineapple. One balloon. But let's sweeten the deal a little bit with 5 pounds of sugar. Sugar that's almost as sweet as my daughter Penny. Thanks, Pen. Let's go one more. 5 more pounds. That's 10 pounds of sugar. 24 pounds of pineapple. Balance carefully. Carefully. And we have our unbreakable balloon. It's not magic. It's science. Hi, everyone. I'm Smarty Pants. What you just saw now wasn't a magic trick. It was real science. Why does one nail pop a balloon, but 1,000 razor-sharp nails doesn't? I could tell you the secret, but it would be much better if you found out for yourself. So here's a tip. You could Google Bed of Nail Science, or better yet, ask your local librarian to show you where the science books are. And I bet you'll find out on your own the secret of the Bed of Nails. Thanks, Penny, for helping me with my science experiment. You always keep me smiling, so I've got a present for you. Just make sure he eats plenty of pineapple. A man goes to the doctor and says, "Doctor, I'm so sad." The doctor says, "Go see Pagliacci, funniest clown in town. Cheer you right up." A lady goes to the doctor and says, "I'm so sad." The doctor says, "Go see Pagliacci, funniest clown in town. Cheer you right up." A man goes to the doctor and says, "I'm so sad. Go see Pagliacci, funniest clown in town." And the man says, "But doctor, I am Pagliacci." And that is why you never let a pigeon drive a bus. Oh, hello. I was just reading a little bit to my friend Robot. Say hi, Robot. Sorry, he's a little shy. Did you know that you can become a much better reader by reading out loud to a friend, like my friend Robot here? And that is why you do not let a pigeon drive a bus. If you don't have a robot friend, you can always read to a little brother or sister, like this baby. Hi, baby. And that is why a pigeon should not drive a bus. Oh, if you don't have a little brother or sister, you can always read to a pet, like Mickey. This book's his favorite. And if you'd like to help a friend like this robot learn to read, the best place to start is learning the alphabet. I learned the alphabet the old-fashioned way, with balloons. A is for apple. Watch out, Snow White. That one's dangerous. B is for balloon. That's an easy one. C is for clown. The funniest clown in town. D is for dog. This one may go pop, but he won't go poop. Your carpets are safe. E is for elephant. He enjoys walks on the beach and reading romance novels. F is for Frankenstein. Creepy. G is for great balloons. My favorite balloon book. H is for hello. Hello, kitty. How you doing? I is for ice cream. My most popular flavor. J is for juggler. My friend Jason is a juggler and his name starts with J too. What are the odds of that? K is for Kermit. It's not easy being green. If you know about video production,
You know what I mean. L is for Lincoln, Abraham Lincoln. He has a whole section at the library. M is for Monkey. He is a banana salesman. Very successful. N is for Ninja. Mysterious. O is for Olaf. He is from Frozen, but I think you knew that. P is for pizza. 4 slices, please, because I can't eat 8. Q is for question. What's inside a balloon? Nobody knows. R is for Rudolph. What are you doing here, Rudolph? It's June. S is for Smarty Pants. Hey, that's me. T is for Teddy Bear. How are you so cute? U is for Underpants. Captain Underpants. V is for Vampire. You should read this book when you're older. W is for Wonder Woman's Invisible Jet. That's my daughter Penny, and this photo's famous. X is for X-ray. Nothing else. There is only X-ray. Y is for yellow. Yellow chicken. You crack me up. Z is for zebra. I didn't have a whole lot of options on this one. Well, I sure hope that helped you learn some of the ABCs. What's that, robot? You want to learn numbers next? I guess we'll start with 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 0.
Why does a pigeon want to drive a bus anyway? It does not make sense to me. A pigeon has wings. He can fly anywhere he wants. A bus is difficult to drive. Training is required. Perhaps I do not understand because I am a robot. I am not a pigeon.
To cancel my trial membership of this hot air balloon? No, I don't want it. It's just not working for me. I don't like the hot air balloon. Cancel my trial membership, please. Hello? Hello? Operator. I'd like to cancel my... I'm calling to cancel my trial membership.
Hi, I'm Smarty Pants. You know, people ask me a lot of questions. Here's a question from my cousin Martine. He lives in France.
Est-il difficile de faire les balloons fantastiques?
Thanks for asking, Martine. It can be difficult to make these kind of fancy balloons. It just takes a little bit of practice. But here's the good news. You can make an awesome balloon at home with just regular balloons you might have around the house, like these. Or maybe you've got some balloons left over from Grandpa's birthday. Happy birthday, Grandpa. You'll need 10 balloons to get started, so go grab some from around the house, and I'll wait. Welcome back. Nice balloons. Let's get started. You'll need 10 balloons total. Now these balloons can be hard to blow up with your lungs, so I usually suggest using a pump. You can get this pump at any party store. And if you don't have a pump, well, ask a grown-up for help. Look for a relative that's got a lot of hot air. We've all got one. Once you blow up one balloon, you'll need to blow up a second. You've got your 2 balloons blown up, tie them together. 2 balloons tied together is called a duplet. Once you've got 2 balloons tied together, do it again. Now you've got 4. Push these 4 balloons all together just like this. This is called a quad. Once you've got 4 balloons tied together, do it again. Now you've got 8. Here comes the tricky part. You're gonna mash all 8 balloons together just like this. Now, you might have to wrestle it a little bit. Just do your best Dusty Rhodes impression, and I think you'll got it. Doesn't have to be perfect, but once you get all eight together, it should look like this. There's just one more step to go. You've got your eight, and now let's get two more into the party. Mash this one into the eight we already just did. Again, this takes a little bit of wrestling, but I know you can do it. And again, it doesn't have to be perfect, but once you get all eight together with the other two, now you've got 10 balloons. And we've got something really fun. This balloon toy is called a Gooby Goo, and it's really fun to play with. Once you get the hang of it, you can add lots of different kinds of balloons to make the Gooby Goo, and get lots of different kinds of flavors. This one's for you sporty types. In France, they call it le football. Let it go, let it go. The cold never bothered me anyway. This one's for my friends in Wisconsin. It's a very amusing balloon toy. Going on a trip? It even comes in travel size. Go Cubs, go. Go Cubs, go. It's robot. It's robot. It's robot. It's robot. Once you get a little practice, you can go bigger. I think we should take this one outside. I hope you had a lot of fun today making things with me, Smarty Pants. If you're interested in learning how to make more things out of balloons, or anything else, you can check out some books from your local library. Ask your local librarian to show you where the books are on how to make stuff.
Football.
Hi, I'm Smarty Pants. A lot of people ask me a lot of questions. Here's one from my cousin Martine. He lives in France.
Quel est le balloon le plus gros que tu as fait?
Thanks for asking, Martine. What's the biggest balloon I ever made? Well, that's a big story. It's actually a big balloon story. You want to hear it? A every summer, your local library hosts summer reading programs to get kids like you excited about reading. For our Have Balloon Will Travel show, I thought, what could I do to get kids excited to come to our big balloon show? How about a balloon? A big balloon. How about an aeroplane? Sorry, I already made an airplane.
How about a motorcycle?
Been there, done that.
You know, Smarty, I really could use a brand new sleigh.
Sorry, Santa, I already made a giant sleigh. But happy holidays. But there's one thing that I never made before. A car. A big car. A really big car. To build a big project like this, I needed some help. So I called some of my best balloon friends to give me a hand. And we all got to work at the library building a big balloon car. It took a lot of work to build that car, and a lot of time. Over 8 hours. And over 2,000 balloons. And when the car was finally done, kid could go right in the car and take a picture. Beep, beep. Then I got a call from WGN Morning News. They're a really big deal. Hello, WGN Morning News? You want me to bring the car to the news station and put it on TV? I'm on my way. So I loaded the big balloon car into a really big real car and drove it right to WGN Morning News.
This thing goes a cool 4 miles an hour.
Millions of kids got to see my big balloon car on TV, and hopefully they got excited about summer reading too. That big balloon car was the biggest balloon I ever made, and the biggest idea I ever had. But you know, I do have some free time on my hands. Hi, I'm Smarty Pants. What you just saw was a real story. Real stories are called nonfiction, and your local librarian can help you find more nonfiction books at the library. A movie about a real thing is called a documentary. You can also find lots of great documentaries at your local library. Ask your librarian to help you pick out some great ones. That's our show for today. I hope you enjoyed watching it. If you liked the big balloon show today, say, "That's great, Smarty Pants." And if you didn't like the show today, say, "That's great, Smarty Pants." I won't know the difference. And if you'd like to see more about Smarty Pants and the big balloon show, check out bigballoonshow.com. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.
The end of the Big Balloon Show.
Bye! Did you know it took a whole month to film this program? And sometimes things didn't go well, didn't go as planned. Have a look. And that is why a pigeon should not drive a bus. Oh, hello. You're still here. I'd like to thank you for watching the Big Balloon Show program. I hope you enjoyed it. And I'd also like to thank the fine folks at the Prairie Trails Public Library for their support in putting this program together. And now that you're here, I'd like to let you in on a little secret. You see, I was supposed to do the Big Balloon Show at the library this summer, but as you can imagine, that couldn't happen. So I created the show you just saw on this, a regular iPad, just like the one you might have at home, or maybe your parents have one. But here's the thing, I didn't know how to create a program like this when I started, so what did I do? I took out lots of books from a library just like this one, and I read lots of articles on this iPad, articles about video production, and I created the show you just saw. Here's the best part. The library has books on everything, video production, and anything else you want to learn. So I hope you start reading this summer, and I hope you'll learn a lot about any topic you're interested in. Well, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.